Good afternoon. We are talking about the globalization tool. So I try to point out some new trends of this new globalization. I think it's number one is we talk about the new paradigm. The facts has shown that catching up model based on the existing industrialization model no longer works. Because after Second World War, with this globalization, more and more countries join this development process. And now we suddenly realize this catching up process cannot go anymore. So we have to change. What we emphasize is sustainable development and inclusive development. So each country now think more about, it's not just high growth rate, catch up, and that's all. And also, I think another new trend is new technology. This new technology are developing so fast, beyond our thinking, beyond our preparation. So almost every day is changing. So we don't know what about the future 20 or 30 years, what kind of world we will be in, live in. So we have to think from now on how to, the impact, and also how to use this new technology to fit for this new paradigm. And also, lastly, I think very important change, that is emerging global issues more and more. And aside from climate change, also there are emerging new big globalization. What are these global issues? What these global issues ask us is a common responsibility and governance. Like in the past, during the climate negotiation, developing countries used to ask more for time. But now we realize no country can ask for time anymore. We have to take responsibility from now on together. So such kind of issues, also global governance on economic development issues and so on. That's one thing. Another trend, I think, and country decision makers and people are more emphasize the balanced development. And like China put forward these five new ideas: innovative, coordinated, green, open, and sharing. It's based on this last, lessons, and call on the new ideas of new paradigm. And also now, the second trend is the cooperative development. We changed from, I call it, development cooperation from cooperative development. Because development cooperation in the past emphasized rich countries help the poor. But now actually, cooperative development is asked for us, whether of rich or poor, let us work together. Because we witnessed the declining share of the, assistance from developed countries, and very limited. And also, economic assistance itself cannot help the overall requirements of development. So we call on the new cooperative development, joint designing, joint building, and sharing, and as like One Belt and One Road, based on this idea. Let's work together, And another one, I think, the significance, I think, of in this new time, that is how to combine this liberalization and innovation together. And more importantly, to help for inclusiveness. Because in the past, we see liberalization is good, But liberalization cannot solve everything. But on the contrary, sometimes you see increasing problems, increasing the gaps. Innovation is the same story. Innovation is good, but you can't expect it can solve the social parity and so many things. So I think this we have from beginning, we have to consider about. Also, I think we see the new trends. I call the TPP based on the liberalization only strategy. Doesn't work anymore. And I, during the lunch, I asked the CP, what does it mean by CP? Comprehensive, that it includes more things. Progressive, gradually. I think that's, you know, we have to consider the new things. And also, you see, we have some new trends, FTAP seems nobody mentioned about. And the APEC's role has seems questioned. And RCEP negotiation, we expect concluded last year. Now with this year, we can still cannot conclude. We don't know whether next year we can conclude. So that means the mega arrangements, the process will slow down. Why? Because the countries, decision makers, people concerned more about of the liberalization. Though economic recovery comes back, and both trade investment, we have seen a lot of figures, but it's still uncertain. So we need more. As I mentioned, cooperative development is a newly emerging consensus because you have to improve infrastructure, you have to improve the capacity, and like ASEAN itself, almost 100% of liberalization within the market. You still see, you know, the intra-regional figure is still very limited. The investment within, very limited. So you have to improve the many others and by this regional cooperation, rather than just focusing on liberalization itself. Asia-Pacific is still very crucial for all of us. And Asia-Pacific, we have to keep the region open and keep FTATP like this. But I think we need to do more, because something we seems forgot, like connectivity. We already start in 2014, and also 2015, we make the blueprint for how to implement. And also, this facilitation. Leaders mentioned this year, that is WTO facilitation agreement, how to implement. The research shows facilitation maybe brings more benefit than liberalization, because as shown by the previous speaker, the real problem not on the tariff, the real problem on the non-tariff measures. So facilitation is a key approach to solve this barriers. Lastly, about China, and we all know that China just finished the 19th Party Congress. Brief news I try to mention. One, that is China in the next 37 years, China continue to focus its own economic agenda as a top priority. But with a new direction, new model, new policy. Yesterday, Chinese Public Security Ministry just issued the green license for car drivers. So expect by 2020, most of the cars must use green license. So this kind of new move, I think, very push it very quick. Another, I think, from this party new Congress, they mentioned China will make more contributions to the world and to put more emphasis on this cooperative development agenda.